Hello, Furpals. My name is Skyfire Teospin, and welcome back to my new video. And happily I can say my weekends is over, finally. Oh yeah. But in this video, let's talk about a little bit of the emotionals and the feelings in your arts. So yeah. As an artist and as an animator, I cannot just draw character without playing their role in my arts. So yeah. So let's say if I had to make my character sad, I had to play that role in real life by thinking and remembering something that makes me sad. And then, when I get every single aspect of being sad, I bring that sadness into my character, giving that character little bit more of that emotional level, if you know what I'm meaning with this one. So yeah. So let's say this character is sad, but we have no reason why. So as an viewer, you probably try to figure out why this character is sad. What makes this character sad? Why he is sad? Why? Well, because there can be several reasons why this character can be sad. One of the reasons can be something like this one. I'm just gonna make a cartoon and comic style sad thinking bubble over here. I lost a friend. I lost a friend. And that can make somebody sad. So let's say if you lose your friend and you no more have any friends, someday when you wake up, you open your phone, your friends told you are not my friend anymore. Does that make you a little bit sad? Maybe, in some way, in deep inside you are sad, but you don't see that like that way. You say that, I'm okay, I'm fine, but inside and very deep in you are sad. And that is enough of making good art, basically. At least that works for me. Yeah. Because I'm a writer, I'm artist, and of course I'm an animator also. No, I'm not working in companies whatsoever, but I know those rules by my own, indeed. Let's say I want to make this character happy. Well, I had to give some values and some level of the happiness. What makes me mostly happy? Is it hugs, friends? Is it a video game or maybe new book or maybe something else? In this case, we are gonna use something very stronger than love, and it's friendship. So, let's give this sad furry a meaning of being happy. Let's start by making that sad face into happy face. Then, I have... Actually, that was horrible typing. I have new friend. And that can make somebody happy. So yeah. So let's say that you just meet somebody in your late night party house, or maybe in dog party house, or maybe in dance floor, you found a friend, and you feel very happy. And that feeling can also be converted as in urine drawings, basically. So yeah, you had to just make character who is smiling, and then you have to give that character a reason why that character is happy. I gave this on a reason because I have a new friend that makes this character happy. So yeah. It's a little bit of role playing in your own drawings, basically. So yeah. You can use that method a lot. And I had to say that you had to use that method a lot in your own drawings. Just play your character role by your own and try to draw that feeling into your characters. And you soon supposed to see that I made an happy character or I made an angry character. How we can make this how we can make this a mad? So we start, of course, with kinda from sad face. But then we also need to. Actually, that's not angry, but this is basically a disappointment feeling. Yeah. Well, forget that angry part. Because I'm not usually angry and I'm not usually mad, so it's really hard to play that role. But I must be filled by own happiness, sadness, disappointments in my life. Those three feelings, they are mostly my feelings what I use into my arts. But happiness and sadness or joy is mostly what I use in my drawings, basically. Yeah. So if you truly like to make something really alive and something like that feels right and feels like the character is alive and living person in your drawings, use those emotionals in your arts. Yeah. Never ever ignore emotionals of your characters because you like to mostly try make your character like they would be alive and living beings instead and static robotics and robots who doesn't have any feelings. Just empty feelings. That's not gonna work. Yeah. If you truly like to make your character beautiful and better, give your character emotionals and feelings like happiness, sadness, madness, mad, angry, satisfied, disappointment or something like that. You can use that in your character or your character will be much better, trust me. Yeah. And here's a special tip. If you cannot figure any feelings, try that way and this way. Try a thing and remember something that makes you happy or makes you sad. And when you feel that happiness or sad, keep that feeling in your mind for a while and start drawing. While you are drawing, when you are sad or happy, and if you truly focus by making that character, you can transform that feeling into your character. I use that method a lot in my life, basically. So yeah. And I made this a very simple sketch because I wanted to show you What I use every single time when I'm driving with emotionals and feelings, basically. Yeah. Sometimes that may take a lot of time to get that correct feeling and remember that what makes me happy or what makes me sad. Honestly, I don't remember any time when I was angry. Because I'm not usually angry, I'm not usually mad, so I cannot make that feeling by easily. So yeah. So you probably gonna see a lot of happiness and sadness or something like that in my arts, basically. It's on my way how I express sometimes myself in my drawings. Sometimes when I'm happy, I can make a happy feeling for my character, the presence and showing and expressing that I'm happy at the moment. Or if I'm sad, I can just make a sad image that express that I'm as sad, as an example. It's on my way to show you my feelings, to rogue my art. So yeah. So, this was my lesson for you, from emotionals. But anyways, thanks for watching Furries and Furballs my new video. Keep those tails wagging all the time. Take that pencil in your hand and just, I mean, take that pencil into your paws and start drawing. Let's see what you can come up. If you have a DeviantArt or Fur Affinity, you can always share your drawings with me and I can watch them how you been evolved. But anyways, until next time, Furballs, it's good to be back to working. Yeah. See you next time.